This was years ago, you understand? Back when things weren't set in concrete. Back when you had a way of changing the course of things. If you knew how. She was perfect. She had always been perfect. I wanted to keep her that way. And like this. To be young and older. Somehow. Of course, that's not what it looked like to her. When I came home from school at Christmas, we saw each other, of course. We talked about things, but never that. We talked about love in general, like it was the subject of an essay instead of real. She said it was like jumping off the high dive. Love was. Or like almost getting drowned. Which, honestly, I didn't understand. A long time. You want to know the reason I stopped that night? It wasn't nobility. That's only what I told myself. I have all the time in the world, right? It was that I knew something was about to be taken from us, leaving in its place something we didn't know. Which didn't make her sad. But it did me. You only get a couple of moments that determine your life. Sometimes only one. And then it's gone. Forever. After any great trauma or crisis, after the shock subsides and the nerves stop twitching, you settle down to the new condition of things because you know that all possibility of any more change has been used up. You've seen the pattern finally, because you've stepped back far enough to take in the whole picture. It's too late now to do anything but accommodate yourself to it. And that's it. There's nothing left to do or say. Except that God and nothing have a lot in common.